first flying car. AirCar successfully completed its first intercity flight between Nitra and Bratislava, Slovakia. Stefan Klein, the founder and CEO of R&D firm Klein Vision, piloted the flying car. The first Blade Runner film was set in a futuristic Los Angeles in the year 2019, with acid rain falling from the skies populated with skimmers, or flying cars that zipped along aerial highways. Although technology has advanced in ways that Hollywood could never have foreseen since the film's release in 1982, selfie sticks, killer drones, hashtag politics, hovercraft taxis remain a far-off fantasy, relegated for science fiction novels and theme park rides. Reality of flying cars. Many of us have always been attracted by flying automobiles, but they have always seemed a long way off. Now, a firm called AirCar has inaugurated a 35-minute trip between two international airports in Slovakia, which was finished on June 28th. The vehicle, which has a top speed of 190 kilometers per hour, is a dual-mode car aircraft that has piqued the interest of netizens all over the world. AirCar travel. AirCar successfully completed its first intercity flight between Nitra and Bratislava, Slovakia. Stefan Klein, the creator and CEO of R&D firm Klein Vision, which designed the prototype hybrid AirCar, drove the flying car. Flying cars and the future. Flying cars are, in fact, real, and they may change the way we commute, work, and live in the next decades. From electric gliders to fixed-wing aircraft and quadcopter drones, advances in battery energy density, material science, and computer simulation have sparked the development of a variety of personal flying vehicles and the navigation systems that will allow them to fly. A video of the mesmerizing flight was shared on the official YouTube channel of the company, along with details. How does a flying car work? According to a BBC report, the AirCar is powered by a BMW engine and operates on ordinary petrol. The vehicle can also turn into an aircraft in 2 minutes and 15 seconds, according to the website, with a range of 1,000 kilometers and a height of 8,200 feet or 2,500 meters. The video has received over 1 million views since it was published online, eliciting a barrage of responses from internet users. While many people are captivated by the flying car, others are curious as to when it will be available for purchase. Some joked about avoiding road traffic in these cars as well. These planes may not look exactly like the ones shown in Blade Runner. However, they aren't all that far away. Most are constructed with rotors instead of wings, allowing for vertical takeoff and landing. They are far smaller than a commercial jet. Tilt rotors, for example, enable more efficient forward flight over longer distances, whereas multi-rotors are designed to reduce noise while hovering. Most importantly, these cars are designed to provide individuals with speedier commutes than traditional modes of transportation, especially in congested areas. Klein Vision, the firm behind AirCar, claims the prototype took 2 years to create and cost less than 2 million euros or 1.7 million pounds. Klein Vision's consultant and investor Anton Zayats believes the company would be extremely successful if it could capture even a small percentage of worldwide airline or taxi sales. In the United States alone, there are around 40,000 aircraft orders, he stated. And if we convert just 5% of those to flying cars, we've got a big market. The AirCar is the love child of a Bugatti Veyron and a Cessna 172, according to Dr. Stephen Wright, senior research fellow in avionics and aircraft at the University of the West of England. In comparison to other airplanes, he did not believe the vehicle would be particularly loud or inefficient in terms of fuel expenses. I have to confess, this seems extremely fascinating, Dr. Wright replied, but I have 100 questions regarding certification. Anyone can build an airplane, but the trick is to build one that flies for 1 million hours straight with a human on board without having an accident. I can't wait to see the piece of paper that says this is safe to fly and safe to sell. Other companies. The autonomous urban aircraft market is still a bit of a wild west at present. Dozens of startups are vying for the rights to develop commercial jetpacks, flying motorcycles, and personal air taxis. venture capitalists, auto and aviation companies, and even Uber, with its ambitious Uber Elevate, are laying claims on the emerging market, which may be valued at $1.5 trillion by 2040. Meanwhile, aviation officials are working up the laws and safety requirements that will govern this new mode of transportation. Volocopter. Volocopter, for example, has advertised its VolaCity craft as the world's first commercially certified, electrically driven air taxi, a vehicle that will someday operate without the need for a pilot. Fabian Nestman, Volocopter's vice president of public affairs, compares it to Uber Black or any other premium service. That is, with a few key exceptions. The VolaCity will only have enough for one passenger at first. Volocopter intends to gain consumer confidence before converting to a fully autonomous model, an electric, wingless craft powered by 9 batteries that would transport passengers via a planned network of vertiports, airports for planes that take off and land vertically, spanning major cities. The first commercial flights from VolaCity are expected to begin in 2022. The first flights will be priced at €300, or $350 or £270. However, Nestman claims that the company's ultimate goal is to make the price competitive with, for example, an Uber Black. "We don't want this to be a toy for the wealthy. We want it to be a part of a well-integrated journey for anybody in a city," he says. "Everyone should be able to walk, be driven, ride a bike, or fly." What is the future like? The consequences could change the way we commute and live. Right now, most people optimize their lives depending on transportation access, observes Kopar Dekar. VTOLs and drones will allow us to reach people wherever they are, allowing us to optimize transportation based on where they live. Businesses will no longer need to locate their headquarters in major business areas, and employees will be able to live anywhere within an air taxi's reach. It's possible that owning a VTOL will become as common and affordable as owning a bicycle. VTOLs have far-reaching consequences for the future of transportation, labor, consumption, urban planning, and even healthcare and the environment. Customers may be able to book an air taxi directly to their cloud-tethered office as early as 2030 by pressing a button. "We may eventually have fewer and fewer reasons to descend to the land below, conducting our business and lifestyles above a city in the sky in the decades ahead. 1 mile of road can only take you 1 mile, says Kopar Dekar. 1 mile of aviation can take you anywhere. Head over to our channel to find out more about technology and spacecraft information, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Turn the bell notification so you don't miss out on any videos.